Dear God, thank you for bringing me to the end of this month. I believe the next 6 months will be better and brighter. Yours sincerely.
Hi there, welcome and welcome back to my channel. It's a new month, so happy new month, families. If you're watching this video much later, today is 1st of July 2021, and yet so fast we're already in the middle of the year. And earlier at the beginning of the year, I did a major review video where I shared my goals for the year. If you've not watched that video, I'm going to link it up right now for you to watch before you continue watching this video. You might as well want to watch that video before you continue watching this. And I'm here to do a reset plus review while I carry you guys along, so stay tuned. Note that this is not to create pressure or in any form, because being alive and living alone is big deal enough for this half of the year. However, just like we make to-do lists daily and to plan ahead and have clarity, have an idea of the tasks we want to do, and also to tick out whichever has been achieved by probably like the mid of the day, it is therefore important to review your goal or plan for the year so far. So I'll be ticking off the one I was able to achieve while also re-strategizing on the ones that are yet to be achieved, and also if I would like to upgrade my goal. So I'll also be sharing some tips needed to do your mid-year review. So the first is, list out all your wins and accomplishments for the first half of the year, because it's actually very easy to forget a lot of things that you probably have achieved or things that are like a plus to you, probably because of the happenings. I mean, the last year, a lot of happenings, Mr. Koro and all of those stuff that comes with it. No matter how small or big you think your wins are, it's very necessary to actually acknowledge and celebrate them. So for me, under the list of my wins and accomplishments, I mean, I started and grew my YouTube channel from 0 subscribers to almost 400 subscribers and almost 8,000 views, which gives me some amount of fulfillment. Yes. Secondly, I learned driving. I mean, it was part of my plan for the year, and I'm so excited that I was able to achieve it already, and this is like half year, right? Yes, I started my business, and I'm so excited that also is growing. I got on my dream job or career path, and I'm also excited. Oh, how can I forget my ICANN certification? I'm so excited that I finally got qualified and certified as a professional chartered accountant. Number two is happy moments and gratitude. I mean, you know, it's not necessarily everything that falls under the category of wins and accomplishments. So I'll be sharing some of this under this list. For me, I have started the art of meditation, journalizing, and mindfulness practice. And it has really helped me. Like, it has helped me so far, and I do not plan to drop the habit. I also started to value my mental health more seriously, self-care, self-love. You people, as in and self-confidence. I reconnected with friends, valuable friendship. Yeah, that's very important. Yes, I also became more productive. So far, I feel like I've become more productive. I do not joke with my to-do list, because I feel that it's very important. Guys, I set to-do lists every day. I mean, every day, including weekends. I write down whatever I want to do for that day. I include rest in my to-do list. I include if I need to make some calls. I include the things I want to do from the morning when I wake up to, I mean, for that day, I try to check, no matter how little it seems to be, I write down whatever I have to do for that day. And I also review it when it comes to like midday. I try to check on the ones that I've done. And then so far, it has given me clarity and also helped me, because I don't really know how to keep tab of things, yeah. But when I write it down and then I look at it, I remember this that I want to do, and I get on with it. Yeah, I spoke about visibility in that video, and in terms of visibility, I believe I'm doing well. By that visibility, I was like, I wasn't a social media kind of person really, but I mean, I feel that I have done better, right? Like, I'm a lot better. I actually joined TikTok, and I hope I do not just join it for the fun part alone, even though I was enjoying what I was doing. Yeah, I also got on board with the mental awareness and personal development and self-development aspect of it. And then you guys won't even believe that sometime later I just get on that videos, maybe a day I could film like maybe 3 or more videos, and there was actually a time when I knew that that thing is not just a joke, because it actually blessed me myself. It was a kind of down period, and I was just scrolling through my gallery and saw one of my videos, and I was just smiling. Like, it just really helped me. I was so surprised that I could be blessed by myself. Like, I don't know if you get, like, I was inspired by my own videos. So yeah, yes to that. Like, I emulated some self-development tips and videos. Yes, I also engaged in decluttering. I decluttered my social media recently, and guys, I cannot even explain the peace, or should I call it peace? Like, I just feel, I don't know, like, I think it's part of what made me also more productive, yeah? Like, I mean, yes, I talked about visibility, like, being out there, at the same time, having control. I think that's where this part of decluttering is. I had a lot of control. I wasn't just all out there every time, such that it hinders my productivity. No, I decluttered my social media, shared out some contacts I know that maybe I'm not in connection with, or we are both not adding value to each other. You get me? So it gave me so much. I felt like I'm a bit free, right? I just decluttered my social media generally, and I don't get to show up every time. I show up only when I know that, oh, this time is best for me too, and when I feel like. But when I know that I'm supposed to be productive doing something else other than social media, then I do it. Number 3 are challenges I experienced so far from the beginning of the year till now, and what I have learned from them. Well, I don't really know how to put the challenges. Have I experienced any challenges so far? Well, so far, I would say the greatest of my challenge has been the challenge of this country. Yes! I mean, like, I really wish the state of the country is better. I mean, I want Nigeria to be like a better place. I wish it could just be a sane, stable, and strong economy, strong system, healed society, not a sick one that it is right now. I just wish the country, the state of the country, everything about this Nigeria could be better. But so far, from that challenges, what I've learned so far is that you create your own happiness. Like, you can't wait until life isn't hard anymore before you start being happy. You deserve that happiness, so go for it. Don't wait until tomorrow. It's right now. Yeah, like, right now. Happiness is free. Create your own happiness, and I mean, you will just be fine, because if you think about everything that is going on in this society, in the country, it's enough depression on its own. Yeah. And finally, number 4 for me would be, what do you want to achieve, or what do you want to do in the second half of the year? So in the beginning of the year, I had some goals, right? And this is the way it was aligned. Right now, I mean, I think I have more clarity. I've been able to achieve some. And so while I was doing my reflection, I'll just summarize what I've written down so far without necessarily adding extra goals, and generally not really different from my earlier goals, because having too many goals can dilute your focus. This is not to say that you can't upgrade your goals. If you have more to add to it, yes, by all means, go for it. But this is what works for me at the moment, yeah? So I think I've actually even mentioned some of them along the line. And then I intend to explore more things that interest me, like read more books, work out more, basically join a dance fitness team. Then let go, let God. I also plan saving and investing more, yes. And then as regards my YouTube channel, of course, I intend to be more consistent, yes. And for my faith content, guys, I'll be sharing more series on Sundays and giving you more videos, yeah? So don't say you're not informed, okay? So in summary, faith, finance, family, fitness, are you in alignment? Like, am I in alignment? Yeah, so basically, I think I've kind of streamlined all there is that my goals. I'll just ensure that I become more aligned through other semi-goals, yeah? And that's it, we're done. So I kind of like doing a self-reflection or review, because I believe it gives me motivation, drive, and clarity. I hope you feel the same way and get inspired to also do this same exercise. I mean, like, I'm not necessarily have to wait till December before I feel like I have a fresh start, because as C.S. Lewin said, you can't go back and change the beginning, but you can start where you are and change the ending. So thank you so much, guys, for watching. If you watch up to this moment, a round of applause for you. Thank you so much for staying true. And please do share with me in the comment section your wins so far, big wins, small wins. I mean, it could actually inspire someone else, right? Maybe you got better at managing stress or how to handle anxiety. That's like emotional development, and it's fine. Or you smashed your personal development goals, you started a YouTube channel, you're doing well in your career, any other thing that you feel that is something that you can share and is going to inspire somebody out there, please do well to share in the comment section. Thanks so much for watching again, and see you in my next video. Bye.